Hello friends, I am Dr. Saurabh Shah, working as a retina consultant, Kamalai Hospital, Gulbarga. I welcome to you for the series of videos on eye health. In this particular video, we will be talking about frequently asked questions in diabetic retinopathy. Most of the diabetic patients visiting a retina clinic will be asking these questions, and I feel most of all, or at least maximum people with diabetes should know the answers of the following questions. So what is diabetic retinopathy? Diabetic retinopathy is nothing but the effect caused due to the diabetes or high blood sugars or the fluctuations or long-standing diabetes on the retina. It results in swelling, bleeding and retinal detachments in the late stages. They also ask, how do I know, doctor, that I have got retinopathy? Most of them in whom the retina's important part is not affected, they do not know that they have got a retinopathy, and hence We have to screen. That means that we have to see as many as possible diabetics in a regular interval to know their stage of diabetic retinopathy. Now, what is a stage? Stage is nothing but as there are changes, these changes pass through various stages such as non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, which has mild, moderate, severe, and then there is a proliferative where there can be a high risk of visual loss. So it helps us to treat and stage the patient well. What do you do? What are the tests that frequently done in retinopathy patients? We do fluorescein angiography, where we inject a dye in their forearm or the arm, and then see the blood circulation and know where all, in which areas there is a leakage or there is a blockage of blood. We do an OCT scan to see the functionality of all the layers and to know which layer is working well or no, on how much is the swelling. The most important checkup is a pupil dilated fundus examination. Fundus means retina. So we have to instill drops in the eyes once or twice, which will dilate the pupil. Now, pupil is a part of eye which allows the light to enter into the eye. So if it dilates, more light enters, and hence we can check the retina throughout. What are the frequently done blood tests? HbA1c, serum creatinine, the blood picture and the serum lipid profile are very important before we plan to treat a patient with diabetic retinopathy. People with retinopathy have a higher risk to go into nephropathy, which is a renal failure, and hence we have to have a regular physician checkup too. Now, what are the treatment options available? Treatment options are wide. We have lasers, we have injections, and we have surgery. Injections are mainly given for controlling swelling or diabetic macular edema. In patients who are at risk of bleeding, we can do laser. Laser is done to regulate the blood flow. Patients with retinopathy should understand that the treatment is not possible in one or two visits, and this is a secondary problem happening due to the diabetes. So he has to follow up very frequently and to get his retina checked. So friends, I want you all to share this information with your loved ones and the people you care, and help them to acquire some more knowledge than they have, and to spread the information about diabetic retinopathy. I want to say you all that diabetic retinopathy is a preventable condition. If screened, if detected early, we can avoid and prevent the visual loss which is happening due to it. It usually affects very young adults who are economically viable, so they are their only bread and butter source of their family. So it is very essential for all of us to attend them. I thank you all for a patient listening. See you.